Hello children, welcome all. In last session we have started our new chapter number 1, crop production and management. Let's recall whatever we have learned in the last session and then we continue our chapter. In last session we have learned what is crop, that is what is crop production, the cultivation of one type of plants on a large scale is called as crop production. And this practice of cultivating land for growing crop is known as agriculture. So what is agriculture? The practice of cultivating land for growing crop is known as agriculture. And how does this agricultural practices has started? Due to increasing population, in order to satisfy the demand for food for all, farmers undertake several systematic activities called as agricultural practices. And these crops, if you see, we can classify crops into two types, kharif crops and rabi crops. Kharif crops, that is the crops which are sown in the rainy season, are called kharif crops. And we know that in India, rainy season generally from June to September. And in this season, what are the crops are sown? Example for kharif crops are paddy, maize, soybean, groundnut, and cotton, etc. And what are rabi crops? The crops that are grown in winter season, that is from October to March, are called rabi crops. And examples of rabi crops are wheat, gram, pea, mustard, and linseed. And this agricultural activities, they have several practices, and farmers, they undergo these practices stage by stage. So last session we have learned about first three practices of agricultural practices, namely preparation of soil, sowing, and adding manure and fertilizers. And now let's recall what is preparation of soil. Preparation of soil, plants growth, it depends on soil. So farmers have to prepare the soil very well before sowing the seeds. And this preparation of soil, it is the first important agricultural activity before sowing the seeds. And how do farmers prepare the soil? First, they have to plow the field. So preparation of soil involves plowing, or otherwise called as tilling the land. So plowing, otherwise called as tilling the land. What is plowing? Plowing is nothing but loosening and turning the soil, is called as plowing. Now then we have learned about why this plowing is very, very important. That is nothing but advantages of plowing. Advantages of plowing, children, very, very important. And plowing improves air circulation so that roots can respire easily. Because of the loosening of the soil, roots can penetrate deeper into the soil. So because of this, they enable them to hold the plant firmly. The roots go very deep, then only they can hold the plant firmly. So third advantage is that it enhances the water retaining capacity of the soil. So water is also very, very important for the growth of plant. So because of plowing, it enhances the water retaining capacity of the soil. And as well as plowing, because of plowing, whatever weeds are there in the soil, that is weeds means unwanted plants which are already grown in the soil that will be uprooted, that will be removed, and also it we have learned that it increases the growth of microbes. Microorganism is very, very important because they only add nutrient to the soil. So children, these are all advantages of ploughing we have learned in last session. And this ploughing, then we have learned about agricultural implement. What are all agricultural implement used in ploughing? First one, that is plough. Plough is a traditional agricultural implement used for ploughing. As the name indicates, plough is used for ploughing. Is made up of wooden implement, and it consists of two parts. What are they? Ploughshare and plough shaft. And ploughshare, it consists of triangular iron blade, and which is attached to the beam of wood. What is that called as plough shaft? And one end of the plough shaft consists of a handle to pull the bullock, to pull it. And the other end of the plough shaft consists of contains a log of wood on which is kept on the shoulder of the bullocks, so that it can be easily drawn over the soil. So this is traditional implement called plough, and which is replaced by the implement which is used for ploughing is called as hoe. It is also similar to that of plough, but here you can see that it is that wooden part is replaced by iron rod, and it also consists of one end of the rod. It is attached with a triangular bent plate which acts like a knife, so that it can be easily loosen the soil. And the other end of the rod is attached with a beam of wood, which is kept on the bullock shoulder, so that it will be easily pulled over the land. And one more agricultural implement which is used for ploughing is called as cultivator. It is a modern agricultural implement used for ploughing. This cultivator is driven by a tractor, so that it saves labor and time. So what are the agricultural implements we have learned for ploughing the land? Ploughing, otherwise called as tilling the soil. First one, we have learned about plough, and second agricultural implement, a hoe, and third, it is a cultivator. Cultivator is driven by a tractor. It is a modern agricultural implement used for ploughing. And then second agricultural, say, stage of agricultural practices we have learned, that is sowing. Planting seeds in the soil is known as sowing, and we have learned that sowing can be done manually or by using implement. And seeds can be scattered in the field manually by hand. But what is the disadvantage of this? We have learned, by as it is manually scattered, in some places there will be overcrowding of seeds. More seeds will be fallen in particular place, so that there will be overcrowding of crops will be there. Then all the crops, if they are sown in the same place, they compete with themselves, and they will not get enough nutrients, sunlight, air, etc. So they cannot grow well. So what we have to do, we have to remove some crops. So this, in order to prevent overcrowding, some crops will be removed. This process, what we have learnt, is called as thinning the crop. And second method of sowing the seed is by using special implement called seed drill. And this seed drill also, we have seen two types of seed drill: traditional seed drill and modern seed drill. And traditional seed drill, you can see here, it is sowing. It consists of a funnel shaped structure, and seeds are filled into the funnel, and the seeds pass through this funnel, which consists of two or three pipes which has sharp ends. As this has sharp ends, the it pierces this into the soil, so that the seeds will be placed very deeply into the soil. So it is traditional seed drill. and then we have learnt about a modern seed drill. Nowadays, what this seed drill, which consists of an iron sharp edges sowing the seeds, which consist of pipes at regular intervals, which ensures the seeds can be sown at regular intervals of distance with proper depth, so that seeds will be covered properly by the soil after sowing, and it will not be affected by any predators or it cannot be eaten by birds, and there will not be overcrowding of plants also. And this modern seed drill can be attached with the tractor, so it can be drawn with a, it can be used with the help of tractor. So as it is attached with the tractor, it can save time and labor. So for sowing seeds, again we have learned two agricultural implement. Traditional one, seed drill can be the sowing seeds can be done manually by scattering of the seeds. We have learned about disadvantages of scattering seeds. Then we have learned about seeds can be sown by agricultural implement called seed drill. Then we have seen two types of seed drill: traditional seed drill and modern seed drill. Modern seed drill is attached with a tractor so that it saves time and labor. And then we have learned about soil replenishment, that is plants utilizes nutrients from the soil for their growth. So if the plants, if the crops are continuously grown in the same field, all the nutrients will be utilized by the crops. So how these nutrients can be replenished? By different methods we have learned, that is by crop rotation, by adding manure and fertilizers. So we have learned what is crop rotation, that is planting or cultivating leguminous crops in between two main crops is called as crop rotation. Why do we cultivate leguminous crop in between two main crops? That is because this leguminous crops, roots of leguminous crops contains root nodules where the rhizobium bacteria grows, and this rhizobium bacteria, they fix atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogen compounds and fix it in the soil. And these plants, as they cannot utilize atmospheric nitrogen directly, they absorb this compound of nitrogen from the soil. This nitrogen is very, very important for plant growth. So in this way, this nutrient can be replenished by crop rotation. Then we have learnt about what is manure and what is fertilizer. This manure is nothing but is prepared in the field itself by using animal waste, vegetable waste, and after harvested, whatever this leftover is there, everything can be put in, dumped in a field, and it will be covered by a soil by microorganisms which are present in the soil. They convert that into manure, which are rich in nutrients. And this fertilizers are nothing but inorganic substances or chemicals which are prepared in the factory. And this fertilizers, we have learned some example of fertilizers like urea, ammonium sulfate, superphosphate, and NPK. NPK is one fertilizer name. Name itself, it indicates it gives that specific nutrient like nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Then we have learned about the distinct differences between fertilizer and manure. Fertilizer is a man-made one, that is nothing but a chemical substance, or we can call that as inorganic salt. And manure is a natural substance, and it is obtained by the decomposition of cattle dung and plant waste. And fertilizer, it is prepared in factories. Manure, it can be prepared in the field itself. And fertilizer, they do not provide any humus to the soil, and manure, it provide lot of humus to the soil. and fertilizers are very rich in plant nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, and manure, they are relatively less rich in plant nutrients. But if we use fertilizer continuously, then it leads, as it is a chemical or inorganic salt, it makes the soil infertile. So children, so first three agricultural practices. First one is preparation of soil, then sowing seeds, and then soil replenishment by crop rotation, by adding manure and fertilizer, we have learned. And now we are going to learn about, after once the nutrition is being replenished, next step what farmer does is they have to provide water to the plants. So next procedure, what is that? Is irrigation. So what is irrigation? The supply of water to the plants in the field is known as irrigation. So we all know that water is very, very important for all living organisms. Water is very, for plants, that is, plants get nutrients from the soil. It can, how the soil nutrients present in the soil get dissolved in water. So along with the water, nutrients enter into the plants. So water is very, very important for the plants' growth. Now, from where do we get water? The sources of water. It involves rains, canals, waterways, wells and pumps. And this irrigation is different in different crops, because different crops require specific amount of water at different stages of their growth. That is, crops require, the requirement of water for the crops differ from crop to crop. For example, if you see paddy, that is rice crop, it needs more water. So if you see that paddy crops, it is first transplanted in a waterlogged field and it requires constant irrigation. So it is transplanted, means getting transplanted into waterlogged field. Then on the other hand, for wheat, it is irrigation is needed, water is needed only before tilling. What is tilling? That is nothing but called ploughing. So before ploughing, that soil to be irrigated, and as after that, at the time of flowering stage only. For paddy crops, they need continuous irrigation. Constant irrigation is necessary. So they are transplanted in waterlogged field. But for wheat crops, irrigation is needed only at a particular stage of growth, that is only at the flowering stage. So water irrigation is done for wheat crop is before tilling, that is before ploughing the field, as well as at the time of flowering stage. And farmers have to take care that proper quantity of water to be supplied to the crops. Otherwise, what will happen? Excessive watering can reduce, is very, very dangerous. Excessive watering, if water is provided in excess, it leads to water logging. What do you mean by water logging? Water gets stagnated in the field, in the soil, and this leads to salinity of soil. How this, when water is stagnated in the in one place, soil contains many salts, minerals in it, and this will get dissolved in that stagnated water. Due to sun's heat, the water will get evaporate and the salt will left on the soil, and this makes the soil saline. Saline soil is not fit for growth of crops. And one more disadvantage of excessive watering is it reduces the air in the soil, because when you put more water, the spaces in between the soil particle become very less. So it leads to presence of air, less, it leads to a less amount of air in the soil, and this can damage, if continuous water is there in the soil, it damages the plant roots and it leads them to, it causes them to die. So children, irrigation is very, very essential. Farmer has to irrigate the crops according to the requirement. So we have learned excessive watering is also very, very dangerous. Now let us come to agriculture, this method of irrigation. Farmers, they do different methods of irrigation. Methods of irrigation differ from region to region. For example, some region water will be available in plenty, some region availability of water will be less, and in some region there will be no water at all, scarcity of water will be there. So accordingly, the method of irrigation also differ from place to place. And now let us see about methods of irrigation. If you see that irrigation method, we can classify it into traditional method of irrigation and modern method of irrigation. First, now let us start with traditional methods of irrigation. The traditional methods of irrigation is, it involves any animal, for example, cattle or human is used to draw water or to irrigate plants. And this traditional method, as it involves only animal and human, it is very cheap but it is less efficient. Understood, children? And this traditional method, as it involves animal and human, it is very cheap but it is very less efficient. Now let's see different traditional ways of irrigation. You may have learned in your lower classes different traditional way. See here in the figure, the first way, it is called as moat. It includes pulley system. This, in your village you might have seen the well with pulley. Pulley is used to draw water from the well. So this system is a traditional method. The first traditional system what we have learned is moat, or you can write pulley system. Pulley system, example, moat. And second system, it is a chain pump. You can see that wheel like structure, which is driven by a pump, where because of that water will be drawn from any sources, from a well or from a lake, river, etc. And so second traditional system of irrigation is chain pump. And third figure, if you see, it is called as dekli. And here you can see this dekli, and fourth system is rahat system, and this both are based on the function of lever. Type of different types of lever you might have learned. It is work in the principle of lever system. So moat, it has worked in the function of pulley, and this dekli and rahat, it's work on the principle of lever system. And to draw water, mainly pumps are commonly used for lifting water. These pumps are either driven by diesel, biogas or electricity, or by solar energy to run these pumps. So these pumps are run by diesel or biogas or electricity or by solar energy. So first traditional system, moat, it is only driven by work by human or animal. And next, chain pump, dekli and rahat, and these system are driven by pumps to lift water. These pumps are driven by diesel, biogas, electricity or solar energy. So children, for traditional system we have seen four types. First one is moat. Second is, the moat is a pulley system. Second is chain pump. Third is dekli. And fourth is rahat system. This dekli and rahat system is worked on the principle of lever system. Now we'll pass on to next, modern methods of irrigation. This modern methods of irrigation is used to conserve water. So this also you have learned already. two modern methods of irrigation to conserve water is a sprinkler system and drip irrigation system. So in this sprinkler system, you can see this sprinkler system, where the system is used. This sprinkler system is mainly used in the place where uneven land is uneven and where sufficient water is not available, less quantity of water is there. So in order to conserve water, they use sprinkler system. And if you see the sprinkler system, see the figure in, see the picture in this sprinkler system, you can see that perpendicular pipes at regular intervals having rotating nozzles at the top. And these perpendicular pipes are joined to the main pipeline at regular intervals. When the water is drawn by the pump through that when water enter to the main pipeline, and because of the pressure of the water, when it enters the nozzle, that water comes out from the nozzle, makes it rotate. So the water gets sprinkled evenly on the land as if it is raining. So this sprinkler is mainly useful in lawns, coffee plantation and several other crops where availability of water is very less or not sufficient. And next method is drip irrigation system. And in this system, as the name indicates, water falls drop by drop directly at the near the roots. And this is the best technique, best method to conserve water. And where this drip irrigation is used, where water is very scarce, there is no water at all, and water is conserve water, in order to prevent wastage of water, this drip irrigation is used. And this method is used to grow crops like food plants, gardens, trees, etc. See here, you can see the drip irrigation method. Here this water is will be delivered drop by drop near the roots of the plant itself, so no water will get wasted. So this is drip irrigation method. So in modern method of irrigation, we have seen two types: sprinkler irrigation and drip irrigation system. So for irrigation, mainly two types: traditional system and modern method of irrigation. Traditional method of irrigation, we have learnt about more, which is based on pulley type and chain pump, Dakhli and Rahat system. This Dakhli and Rahat system worked on the principle of lever. And next, modern method of irrigation, we have learned two types: sprinkler system and drip irrigation system.